तो भाई आज हम पढ़ने वाले हैं क्लास 12th एनसीईआरटी हिस्ट्री। सो देर आर थ्री पार्ट्स, थीम वन, थीम टू एंड थीम थ्री। थीम वन मोस्टली डील्स विद द एंशिएंट हिस्ट्री ऑफ इंडिया। तो हम लोग पढ़ेंगे थीम नंबर वन, दैट इज ब्रिक्स, बीट्स, बोन्स, द हड़प्पन सिविलाइजेशन। तो ये जो चैप्टर है मोस्टली हड़प्पन सिविलाइजेशन से डील करता है, उसके रिसोर्सेज सोर्सेज के बारे में पढ़ेंगे कि कहाँ से हड़प्पन सिविलाइजेशन के बारे में हमको मालूम चलता है। सो इन द फर्स्ट फिगर वी सी देर इज अ सील, हड़प्पन सील इज देयर। यहाँ पर एक एनिमल मोटिफ है, मीन्स एनिमल का एक फिगर बना हुआ है, ऊपर में कुछ स्क्रिप्ट लिखा हुआ है। सो दीज टू आर द मेन फीचर्स ऑफ हड़प्पन सील्स वी मोस्टली फाइंड इन हड़प्पन साइट्स। सो मोस्ट ऑफ द सील्स हैव एन एनिमल मोटिव एंड देर इज अ स्क्रिप्ट ऑल्सो, बस बट द स्क्रिप्ट इज स्टिल अनडेसिफर्ड। और ये एनिमल भी हमको कहीं दिखता नहीं कैसा ये एनिमल है, ठीक है। तो ये अपना फर्स्ट पॉइंट है। सो वी सी सम टर्म्स, प्लेसेस एंड टाइम्स ऑल्सो। सो इंडस वैली सिविलाइजेशन इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड हड़प्पन कल्चर। वाई हड़प्पन कल्चर, वाई इट इज कॉल्ड कल्चर? बिकॉज एक्चुअली कल्चर रिफर्स टू अ ग्रुप ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट्स डिस्टिंक्टिव इन स्टाइल दैट आर यूजअली फाउंड टुगेदर विद इन स्पेसिफिक जियोग्राफिकल एरिया एंड पीरियड ऑफ टाइम। इन द केस ऑफ हड़प्पन कल्चर दीज डिस्टिंक्टिव ऑब्जेक्ट्स इंक्लूड सील्स, बीड्स, वेट्स, स्टोन्स एंड ब्लेड्स एंड इवन बेकेड ब्रिक्स। These objects were found from areas as far as Afghanistan, Jammu, Balochistan, which is in Pakistan now, and also Gujarat. So named after Harappa, the first site where this unique culture was discovered. The civilization is dated back to 2600 BCE to 1900 BCE. These were earlier and later cultures, often called early Harappa and late Harappa culture in the same area. The Harappa civilization is sometimes also called matured Harappan culture to distinguish it from these cultures. So here we can see in the figure there are a number of the objects that we find from this culture. Beads are there, weights are there, and blades are there, right? So here we have a map of Harappan sites. So in the north, extreme north, we have in Jammu, Manda. Jammu Kashmir mein Manda hai. In the westmost area, we find Sutkajan Dor. Theek hai? So there are some abbreviations that which are very important. BP. BP stands for before present. BCE stands for before common era. And CE stands for, generally stands for AD. We can call it AD. And C dot. C stands for Latin word circa, which means approximate. So jahan bhi C use hoga, it means we are saying that approximate. Okay. So beginning of this culture, let us see what happens. There were several archaeological cultures in region prior to mature Harappa. Okay, there were several archaeological cultures in the region prior to mature Harappan. These cultures were associated with distinctive pottery, evidence of agriculture and pastoralism, and some crafts. Settlements were generally small and there were virtually no large buildings. It appears that there was a break between the early Harappa and Harappa civilization, evident from large-scale burning at some sites as well as abandonment of certain settlements. So, matured Harappan culture ke pehle bhi kafi sare culture thi. It was not the only culture that existed there. Okay, we also have some evidences to show this. So, next is subsistence strategy. So we already seen some maps, map number 1 and 2. So you will notice here that mature Harappan culture developed in some of the areas occupied by the early Harappan culture. These cultures also shared certain common elements including subsistence strategies. The Harappan ate a large or wide variety of the plants and animal products including fish. Archaeologists have been able to reconstruct dietary practices from finds of charred grains. Charred grains means jale hue jo grains hain and seeds. These are studied by archaeobotanists who are specialists in ancient plant remains. Grains found at Harappan sites included wheat, barley, lentil, chickpea and sesame. So these are important grains, you have to remember it. Millets are found from sites in Gujarat. So in Gujarat we find millets. Finds of rice are relatively rare. So they are mainly what they produce was wheat, barley, lentil, chickpea and sesame. Animal bones found at Harappan sites include those of cattle, sheep, goat, buffalo and pig. Studies done by archaeozoologists or zoo archaeologists indicate that these animals were domesticated. Okay, so domesticated animals were cattle, sheep, goat, buffalo and pig. Bones of wild species such as boar, deer, gharial, So boar, deer, gharial were the wild species found over there. We do not know whether the Harappan hunted these animals themselves or obtained meat from other hunting communities. Bones of fish and fowl are also found. So here we have map number 2, areas of early Harappan occupations. So Saswal is there, Sadat is there, Kot Diji is there, and Ambrinal is there. Okay. Agricultural technology ke baare mein baat karte hain. While the prevalence of agriculture is indicated by finds of grains, it is more difficult to reconstruct actual agriculture practices. Were seeds broadcast on plugged lands? ठीक है. Representation on seals and interrogative sculpture indicate that bull was unknown. An archaeologist extrapolate from this that oxen were used for plugging. Oxen का use करते थे plug करने के लिए और bulls जो थे they were also known. Moreover, terracotta models of plow have been found at sites in the Cholistan and Banwali, Haryana. Archaeologists have also found evidences of plug field Kalibangam. तो Kalibangam में अपने को एक plug field मिलता है राजस्थान में. Okay. Associated with early Harappan levels. The field had two sets of furrows at right angles to each other, suggesting that two different crops were grown together. Archaeologists have also tried to identify the tools used for harvesting. Okay. Most common sites are located in semi-arid lands where irrigation was probably required for agriculture. Traces of canals have been found at Harappan sites of Shorchughai in Afghanistan, but not in Punjab or Sindh. Why sources of irrigation has not been found in Punjab and Sindh? It is possible that ancient canals that were there in Punjab or Sindh, they have silted up long ago. It is also likely that water drawn from wells was used for irrigation. Besides, water reservoirs found in Dholavira, Gujarat may have been used to store water for agriculture. तो जनरली अपने को अगर सोर्स ऑफ इरीगेशन की बात करें तो वी फाइंड सोर्स ऑफ इरीगेशन इन अफगानिस्तान एरिया, बट इन पंजाब एंड सिंध सोर्सेज ऑफ इरीगेशन आर नॉट देयर, मीन्स कैनल्स आर नॉट देयर. सो जनरली वाटर वॉज ड्रॉन फ्रॉम बिग वेल्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल वी कैन सी अ रिजर्वायर इन डोलावीरा. ओके, सो वी कैन सी सम कॉपर टूल्स आर देयर. एंड ढोलावीरा में एक रिजर्वायर है, इट इज़ नॉट, इट इज़ अ मैसनरी रिजर्वायर, मैसनरी वर्क. ओके, रिमेंबर इट. हाउ आर्टिफैक्ट्स आर आइडेंटिफाइड? देर इज अ सैडल कोर्न फाउंड इन कंसिडरेबल नंबर्स एंड दे सीम टू हैव बीन द ओनली मीन्स इन विच आर यूज फॉर ग्राइंडिंग सीरियल्स. तो ये सैडल कोर्न है और इसके बारे में हमको पता चलता है फ्रॉम अर्नेस्ट मैके. अर्नेस्ट मैके ने एक्सक्यूवेशन किया था और ये सैडल कोर्न अपने को मिला था. ठीक है, नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज मोहनजोदड़ो, दैट इज मोस्ट डिस्कस्ड टॉपिक ऑफ इंडस वैली सिविलाइजेशन. सो परहैप्स द मोस्ट यूनिक फीचर ऑफ हड़प्पा सिविलाइजेशन वॉज द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ अर्बन सेंटर्स. लेट अस लुक एट सम एट वन सच सेंटर, दैट इज मोहनजोदड़ो मोर क्लोजली. Although Mohenjo-daro is the most well-known site, the first site we discovered was Harappa. So remember it. First site discovered was Harappa, then after Mohenjo-daro was discovered. The settlement is divided into two sections, one small but higher and the other much larger but lower. Archaeologists designate these as citadel. So higher section is called citadel and the lower town respectively. Higher section is called citadel and the lower town was simply for the common people. The citadel owes to its height to the fact that buildings were constructed on mud bricks platform. It was vault, which meant that it was physically separated from the lower town. The lower town was also vault. Okay, the higher town or the citadel was vault, the lower town was also vault. Several buildings were built on the platforms which served as foundations. It has been calculated that if one laborer moved roughly a cubic meter of earth daily just to put the foundation in place, it would have required 4 million persons day. In other words, mobilizing labor on a very large scale. So it was one of the important feature of Indus Valley civilization, mobilization of labor. Consider something else here. Once the platform was in place, all building activity within the city was restricted to fixed area. So it seems that settlement was first planned, then implemented. Other signs of planning include bricks, which whether sun-dried or baked, were of the standard size. So here we see the plight of Harappa. Although Harappa was the first site to be discovered, it was badly destroyed by the brick robbers. As early as 1875, Alexander Cunningham, the first Director General of Archaeological Survey of India, ASI, often called the father of Indian archaeology, noted that amount of bricks taken from the ancient site was enough to lay bricks for about 100 miles of railway lines between Lahore and Multan. Thus, many of the ancient structures at the site were damaged. In contrast, Mohenjo-daro was far better preserved. So drainage system was one of the important feature of Indus Valley sites. So here we can see a picture of drain in Mohenjo-daro. Okay, there is a huge opening of the drain. So how the drains were laid, let us see. One of the most distinctive feature of Harappan cities was carefully planned drainage system. If you look at the plan of the lower town, you will notice that roads and streets were laid out along approximate grid pattern, means perpendicular to each other, intersecting at right angles. It seems that streets with drains were laid out first, then houses built along them. So streets were built, then drains were built, then houses were built. If domestic wastewater had to flow into the street's drain, every house needed to have at least one wall along the street. So already we have seen what is citadel. Citadel was actually the raised portion of the city, while most of the Harappan settlements have small high western part and larger lower eastern section. There are some variations also. At sites such as Dholavira and Lothal, Lothal is in Gujarat, the entire settlement was fortified, and sections within the towns were also separated by walls. The citadel within Lothal was not walled off but was built at height. So Lothal mein jo citadel hai us pe wall nahi tha, boundary wall nahi tha. So let us see some domestic architecture. The lower town at Mohenjo-daro provides example of residential buildings. Many were centered on the courtyard with rooms all sides, means beech mein courtyard hota tha, uske charo room hote the. The courtyard was probably the center of activities such as cooking and weaving, particularly during hot and dry weather. What is also interesting is an apparent concern for privacy. There are no windows in the walls along the ground level. Besides, the main entrance does not give a direct view of the interior or the courtyard. Okay, every house had its own bathroom paved with bricks, with drains connected through the walls to the street drains. Some houses have remains of staircase to reach a second story or the roof. Many houses had wells, often in the room, that could be reached from outside and perhaps used by passerbys. Scholars have estimated that the total number of wells in Mohenjo-daro was almost 700. Okay, so this is the figure, or this is the outline, or the top view we can say. So this is isometric drawing of large house in Mohenjo-daro. So now talk about citadel. It is the citadel that we find evidence of structures that were probably used for special public purposes. These include the following. First is warehouse, a massive structure of which the lower bricks portion remain, while the upper portion, probably the which was made up of wood or something else, decayed long ago. And there is a great bath also. The great bath was a large rectangular tank in the courtyard surrounded by corridor on all the four sides. There were two flights of steps on the north and south leading into the tank, which was made watertight by setting bricks on edge and using a mortar of gypsum. There were rooms on three sides, in one of which was a large well. Water from tank flowed into the huge drains. Across a lane to the north lay a smaller buildings with eight bathrooms, four on each side of the corridor, with drains from each bathroom connecting to drain that run along the corridor. Uniqueness of the structure as well as the context in which it was found has led scholars to suggest that it was meant for some kind of a special ritual bath. ओके, तो अगला टॉपिक हम लोग दूसरे लेक्चर में देखेंगे।